You know, I'm not gonna lie, though I have been doing the post-commentary for these videos, and this is the first one that we're actually doing live again, it's been a while since I've actually held a GameCube controller in my hands, and really the only console I've been playing recently is Breath of the Wild, obviously on the Switch. And the GameCube controller feels a lot larger than the one for the Switch does. This feels very much larger and a little bit heavier by comparison. It's very weird, because I'm so used to the GameCube controller. Hey guys, what's up? Himarth Roy here, and welcome back to Let's Play Mario Superstar Baseball. In the last episode, we continued recruiting Wario's team, or at least what we could of it, because Wario and Waluigi are both not recruitable whenever you're playing as Bowser. This goes for any difficulty, in case you're wondering from last episode. But we still have one more character to get here, Magic Koopa, who has got two flags of four recruited. So once we take care of that, we can move on to our next opponent. Play ball! So without further ado, let's play ball. And start with a home run, that's a good idea. Just right off the bat. Yeah. Beautiful. First pitch of the game, and it's over the fence. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. What a good way to start. Alright, I'm definitely excited for this. I was really concerned I was going to be kind of rusty, but apparently, even with that one out, a home run on literally the first pitch of the game. Good sign of things to come. Let's keep it going. With a very awkward grounder that still scored a base hit, somehow. Just keep hitting it up that line, man. I mean, if that keeps working, then we'll just keep doing it. So hopefully everybody's doing well. Today is the 2nd of April. So hopefully nobody played any horrible jokes on you. I would say yesterday, but I know this is going up much later than yesterday, so hopefully nobody played any jokes that you actually fell for on April 1st. I saw a few on Facebook here and there, mostly Zelda Informer trying to be funny and, like, not doing a good job at all. It was very obvious that they were April Fools. Ah, no, I know what's gonna happen. Oh, no, we're fine. Keep going. Perfect. Exactly what I was hoping for. Beautiful. Ah, I was hoping for score run to possibly show up there, but oh well. Well, I mean, at the rate we're going, it may not matter. No, it will probably matter. I don't think I could score another 6 runs and 4 outs. But we shall see. It'll be nice to actually try and start getting at least one of these a week. Aw, man, it looked like he wasn't... Of course, he's a lot taller, so it's kind of hard to tell. Hopefully, I'll be getting to at least record, like, I don't know, one video a week again. I've been having to play massive catch-up with classwork again. And going to be have to basically smash through, get it to- Oh, don't make me do that! Fine. Of course, you know he's just, like, not gonna swing at it at all. Oh, wow, we actually got it! Nice! Impressive! I didn't think we were gonna get it. I honestly thought he was gonna touch first before we got to him. Booyah! Man, I'm on fire! Speaking of being on fire, here's me not even bothering to try to hit that normally with Bowser Jr. Yeah, that effect won't work on him since he grabs the ball with magic instead of, like, properly picking it up. I was gonna say, don't tell me that's going over the fence on the other side, too. I can accept that, you know? I'm okay with that. Perfect. Runners on second and third. And the almighty Boo Buddy. Fear my ability to hit foul balls. That's the thing, though. Like, he fouls out a lot, but when he does connect, it usually does a very good job of getting outside of the infield, but not so high up that it's easy to catch. I'm gonna say the right one. Nope, definitely not the right one. Alright, you just gonna spam it 3 times? That was a lot slower than I was expecting. He must be running out of energy. Oh, really? And of course, it was the left one twice in a row. Congratulations, you managed to strike me out with one legitimate pitch. And yeah, he was tiring out, so... Because you would think maybe it's just a case of, oh, once the little sweat thing appears, they're just automatically tired out. No, they actually do wear down as time goes on, even though it's not visible other than the pitch itself. The problem with getting Wario out, though, is he's got a team full of Magic Koopas and Waluigi. And all of those are good choices for pitchers. Like, really, the only bad choice of pitcher... Well, I don't even know about Petey Piranha, I was gonna say. Maybe Petey Piranha, but... Waluigi's good. Boo's very good, obviously, since I used him. The Magic Koopas are pretty good. King Boo isn't as good as Boo. He actually curves the ball right instead of left, but he's still pretty decent. I don't know about Petey Piranha, though. So, potentially, the captain could be the worst, Oh, really? Come on. That should have been fine. So, in theory, I guess Wario could actually be the... Well, no, because his pitching stat's high. It's probably Petey Piranha, if I had to guess. Okay, seriously? I saw you reach out to catch that, and then nothing. We're not going to give away a 6-point lead just because the game feels like it. That's not going to happen. Yeah, I had a feeling they're going to start using star swings, which means we can probably expect another one right now. Nope, he didn't swing at it. I've noticed that usually the computer player, if they use a star swing and they don't hit the ball, they're liable to try it again right afterwards. So I was expecting him to at least take a swing at it, but he didn't do it. Sure, something a little bit different here. Go, Chompy! All those Magic Koopas. I held up, but sure. I mean, up and right are, you know, pretty much the same thing. Except not at all. Nah, they definitely scored there. Should actually focus and at least end the second inning before they score again. Hard left. I know what you were planning there, game, by the way. Don't think I didn't know. You're waiting for me to get hit by the chomp. And Waluigi's really not that great of a batter. He might be able to get a base hit, but there's no way he's... Hey, we're not in danger of him hitting this over the fence. I know it's happened before, but that was when I was controlling him, not the CPU. His star swing is gone, so he can't use that anymore. No, I've already made the mistake a couple times. I was gonna go back to the center of the mound and curve it hard left, but they've hit it twice in a row after I've done that. And then he just decided, you know, not to swing at it at all for whatever reason. Maybe he stopped caring, I don't know. Don't remember how Drybones bats if you don't charge swing. Apparently not very well. That's good to know. Not let them get that star chance. If I remember, Magic Koopa star swing's kind of obnoxious. He's like one of the few characters that actually has a noticeable star swing that's not a captain or a co-captain. It goes like super fast down the okay, good. It goes super fast down from the mound to the batter's box for the first half, and then the second half it just slows to a crawl. Like, even worse than that just did. No, not falling for that. Alright, we'll stick 1-1-3. I could maneuver around and get Baby Bowser a second, but I'm not gonna try to do that. That was the worst part. The second I hit that ball, I started mashing X because I knew it was going to get thrown right at shortstop, and it still didn't matter. I feel like it should be possible to, like, save your other runners, and sometimes they just do not make it possible. Switch Bowser Jr. out. For some reason, I can't get the dive and catch to work with him. Yeah, he's just jumping. Yeah, I don't think so. You guys are probably gonna score a couple more runs, but I'm not gonna let you just immediately get it right here. Yep, they are. They're actually gonna catch up, aren't they? I'll bet you anything scores gonna be 8-7 at the end of this inning. I started off super well, and it's just gonna all go downhill because for once I tried to be confident in my skill. Yep, that's exactly what's gonna happen. They're gonna keep scoring until they get to 8-7. Unbelievable. I haven't done in a while. And apparently it's still not gonna work. I can't, they're gonna win. Unbelievable. There is no way they're about to just win this. Had a very good lead of 6-0, and they're about to come back and score 8 runs. Not today! Okay, I lied, I'm still rusty. It's been a while. Good gosh, that was way too close for comfort. Way too close for comfort. No more of that! Yeah, I believe that was probably for a big play. Yeah, it's for big play. That makes sense. Dry Bones is actually pretty easy to get everything for. MVP and 3 strikeouts you can probably get at the same time as long as your pitcher does really well and nobody does anything on the batting side of things, like hitting a home run, then you could probably give it to him. So, if you really ever want to make anybody the MVP, just set them into the pitcher's position and make sure you don't do anything like hit home runs, and you will usually be fine. Alright, 13 minutes, let's see, we've got... Do we have time for one more game? Oh, let's let Bowser have some fun. I've come to kidnap him, I've come to play a baseball game. Play fair and square, you're Peach, that doesn't happen. Anybody who's watched Mario Party 1 knows you're evil. We won, but there was absolutely zero progress made. Fantastic. It's the best kind of progress, is none. Not even anything for star missions. Oh yeah! Alright, round 2 of this. No, I did not lose. As you can see, no flags were collected here. No progress equals why bother showing. At least in the case of this game. As fun as the Mario Baseball series is, I'm sure after watching exhibition for the other 5 captains, and now a 6th one, I mean, you could really only watch so much of this game. Which is why I try to regulate it at least a little bit. That was a fair? Alright, whatever. I sincerely doubt that it might have been, but it did not look like it. The yellow streak that's behind it whenever you charge swing at it kind of makes it hard to tell, though. If you think I'm swinging at that, you've clearly lost your mind. That worked. Alright, Bowser, make me proud. Yep, that sure is making me proud. That was not an out. Nope, that's an out. Great. Just great. Sit. No! No! You have got to be kidding me. Alright, seriously, now you're just trying to make me angry. This mission, finish them off in three batters, appeared in all three innings of the game that's not being shown. Every single one. And every single one, the same thing happened. The first person that came up hit the ball, and then I literally just did like this, right down the center of the plate for the next three batters, and none of them took a single swing at it. Not a single one. They literally just stood there and let the game end knowing that I did not get any scout flags. Which is why I cut the video out, because that is beyond stupid. And now it's just going to happen again, because Daisy will hit the ball, likely after the second strike goes by, and then it won't matter anymore. Error? Okay, good. This isn't the Fairy Queen, I'm tired of error. I had to write a 5-page paper about error. Actually, that story is actually very good. If you haven't read Fairy Queen, it's definitely worth reading. Good gosh, don't you dare start with those stupid blocks. That was not safe. Alright. The Boomerang Bro was not out, and the Hammer Bro was clearly not safe there. Somebody's getting a point this game. You mark my words. So just swinging with them actually does seem to work a little well. I might stick with that for both the Dry Bones, then. I'm not swinging at that. In case you're wondering, it is possible to curve that pitch, by the way. The Heart Ball, or the Flower Ball. You can curve it, and in fact, you can make it still be a ball by curving it too far. So be careful if you're going to do that. Really, you probably don't need to. Most people don't ever even bother swinging at it because they know it's incredibly hard to actually hit it at all. Which is why she's going to use it for the next two pitches. See, she just got a ball right there with it. Alright, I was not expecting... Alright, you can just stand there and watch it if you want. I mean... They realized they were on TV, so they started watching themselves on TV, not doing anything. Yeah, unfortunately, that's another problem with Perfect Catch, is specials like that don't work on them. The Fireball will work on him, it will still burn him. It's one of the very few ways you can make him not get Perfect Catch to work, is because, you know, you just set him on fire. Bullet Bill, however, will work. Or will not work, and he will just catch the ball anyway. He will not skid back or anything. Which seems a bit unfair, because Perfect Catch means you're guaranteed not to get an error. You're still sliding back, or you'll catch the ball anyway, you're just sliding back. It doesn't mean you didn't catch the ball. Nope. There's your fair ball, see if I care. See, King Boo's already doing a better job than Bowser Jr. I think Albert thinks he has all these great ideas, but he hasn't come up with one strategic idea yet. That's not what I did. At least finish him off in three batters while I'm here for the umpteenth time. Yeah, I know what it's gonna be. It's gonna be, yeah, don't let him score. It would be the purple one that's going to give me grief. Please let this work. Alright, now we're doing the only thing that makes sense. Trying to scare him away from that side. Yeah, He's not having it. Alright, fine, whatever. I saw first base trying to steal for that. Don't think I didn't see it. I mean, you have two outs and you have to swing at it. Of course, everybody's just gonna book it. Like, what else would you do? It's not gonna be any backlash to doing it. I mean, you're screwed either way. So, I guess that makes sense. It is Bowser, so. Oh my gosh! That was awesome! That sent him all the way back to right field! I've never seen that happen before, because usually I don't bother with the star swing for Bowser. That was cool! Yep, out and out. Of course it won't matter. Because there was a mission, there was no chance of me getting it. Had there been no mission, probably would have been okay. So we have, what, one for each? Now we have two for each. I thought we had one for each, whatever. Let me back in the game. Put me back in, coach. The game has now stopped caring entirely. They swung at it like halfway before it even got there. I think the game's good. Oh, well, maybe not. They're at least getting a base hit because there's a mission. If there's a mission, it must happen. I'm sure there's like comments all over the thing. It's like, well, if you actually varied your pitches, that wouldn't be a problem. You always throw it super fast. No, screw you. I will recruit you to put you on the sidelines the rest of the game. Technically, it would be the rest of the game unless he came up as an AI again, because this is the last story mode to do. So technically, yes, that is true. It would be for the rest of the game. So did we get? We didn't recruit any characters, but we got three for each. I think's what happened. Well, that's better than the Wario one, I guess. Of course Bowser won. Bowser always wins. Haven't you played Bowser Land in Mario Party 2? Bowser beats Peach. It's just like a rock, paper, scissors thing. Bowser always beats Peach. Let's go with this one again. I'm playing these minigames in case you're wondering to actually pick up the last item for the last match of the game. The Superstar, whatever it's called. I am gonna grab that at least once. Really doesn't matter who you use for this. I am not setting it to normal or hard difficulty. Yes, I know, I'm not making any noise other than just this clicking. But you kind of have to concentrate on what you're doing in this one, so. Ow! Rude. Alright, 16. Wow, fourth place did awful. That was terrible. Third place almost did twice as good as him. But yeah, in case you're wondering what my strategy for that is, I've got pretty decent peripheral vision, so I'm watching the eggs on the conveyor belt the entire time, or the little lineup. I don't actually ever look at the piranha plants, and I can just see them out of peripherals, and so just throw whatever color it is. If it's a bomb, you can throw it at anything, or I'll just hit B and throw it at another player, and then purple can get hit by anything, of course. So I think I need 800 for that. I think the Superstar also does change depending on what difficulty you're playing on, the price of it does. Much like all of the other starting items here. Why is this not here? That's really weird. Yeah, it is 800. Why is the buddy badge not here? Is it because he's Bowser? No, surely it's not. I don't actually know the answer to that. That should be there. I could have sworn it was. Can you actually not pick up the buddy badge while you're playing as Bowser because he's the villain of the game? Because that's pretty funny if you can't. I'm gonna have to look into that later. Alright, whatever. All bills improve, you'll truly feel like a superstar. Yeah, I don't have the money. But we'll work on it. For now, let's make sure to actually save the game. At least I didn't remember to make, or at least I didn't make that mistake by not remembering again. I just don't remember how to words, because words are hard. Gosh dang it, words, why do you have to make everything difficult? Next time on Let's Play at Mario Superstar Baseball, we will continue with the Bowser team. Shouldn't be that, we should probably be able to get the rest of Peach's team taken care of. After that, we've got DK, Yoshi, and Mario left, so between those three, I don't know. Maybe we'll just do something weird and go fight Mario. We'll let him know we've got the princess's team, even though the princess herself is still in the castle. And we'll figure it out. See you guys next time.